Well, you know, take my hand. Though you know, let me stay and walk along. I can see by the deep furrowed frown on your face that someone has done you wrong.
You're right, I've been wronged and it's you to blame. So where is your guilt and your shame? Have you no got the guts to behave like a man? Though you prove that to your fame a claim.
That whispered smooth words in your ear, so you no longer love but you fear. A man such as I would much rather die than go gambling with your hand, my dear.
Oh, spare me your falsehoods, your lame words and prattle. Your heart and your words are so cold. I wouldn't have believed it, much less have conceived it, had it no been your brother who told.
Please listen to me. No, he's my brother, but he's lying to you. My brother has loved you, has done from the start. He wants you to leave me and sell in your heart. Do you see? He's still my love. Still my love.
Still my love. Still my
together in the end. Brolum, Lovers, Tiff. And that's from the 2004 album, The Fair Face I Never Saw, Brolum's second album following the success of 7-11. You're listening to The Garden Sessions, gardensessions.co.uk. Contact us at podcast@gardensessions.co.uk. We're available in Radio Britfolk, radiobritfolk.co.uk, and 98.8 FM in the Edinburgh area. I'm talking, of course, about Leith FM, where Leith lives. I'm Jack Foster, and joining me, as ever, I wanted to say our very own tiffing lovers, but apparently I'm not allowed to do that. So It's the tabloid and broadsheet of the folk scene. I'm talking, of course, of Frank Burkitt and Dave the Angles Gimble.
Well, we know who the broadsheet is, don't we, Dave?
Well, you.
Yes.
Because you're refined and sophisticated and intelligent.
And suave.
Yeah, and I'm swimming in half-naked ladies.
Moving on. Shall I tell everybody what's coming up on the show?
Why not, Frank? Yes, yes.
Possibly. We've got all the usuals. I'll just drop my notes.
Do you want mine, Frank?
Yeah, no, it's fine. I think I know what the usuals are.
You should know what they are.
The angle, of course, and we've got the letters bag.
Hint, Dave.
Hint?
I need a hint for the angle.
Hint, right. Okay.
Bring it.
The song involves a tree.
My bonny yew tree?
Possibly.
Is it?
No.
Right. So we can look forward to the angle, which isn't My Bonnie
New
Tree.
And the download chart, of course, the official Garden Sessions download chart.
Will Sophie Stair's Scura still be at number one?
I think, well, I don't know. I haven't a clue.
Dave, you know.
Dave
any hints? Tell
hints?
Us how many climbers,
hints on
how many
everything.
Followers,
well,
how many...
You don't get hints on the download chart. That
you can tell
unfair.
Us how many ups and downs and things.
But more importantly, listeners,
in fact,
more
I've
importantly...
I've got wind that there are three re-entries, four non-movers, one climber and one new entry.
But as I said twice already, more importantly...
More importantly,
we had the Junction Pool.
Yes.
Featured artist, yes, which Dave, your mission was successful.
Yeah. I found it.
Did you reward the Huskies?
No, I didn't need Huskies. You reliably informed me that it wasn't in your bag, and guess where it was, Jack?
No, that's not entirely
it was in
true,
Jack's bag.
Dave, at all, I think. Is the
I
case.
Think that's slander.
No, yes,
that's
probably.
What it is.
That's where it we was. Are coming to you from the cellar of the Royal Oak once again.
Back here again.
Displaced
the pleasure.
From the Bothy.
Pleasure, not a tour.
Of course. We've got a pint of Guinness here, and. Well,
any number of new glasses if we happen to break ours.
We're laughing, basically.
Dave, tune.
Tune. The next tune we're going to have is Emily Smith, and it's called Song for...
No, it's called... it's called Strong Winds for
Autumn. Dave, you don't sound like you're motivated here, Dave. Come
I am
on.
Motivated. It's the poltergeist they're getting to.
Quick.
It's called Strong Wind for Autumn.
Fear cry of the gulls filled the air as I watched. The day my Annie sailed on the last boat down the whipping hall. Sail away, my Anne and love. No breeze can catch you now. It's all clear. There's only memories here. This year will know no winter. Sail away, my Anne and love. No breeze can catch you.
Different Life, released earlier this year. More info at emilysmith.org. That's Emily Smith, Strong Winds for Autumn. And Angles is in tears. He's gone through a whole box of tissues. It's a sad song.
Man-sized tissues.
Man-sized. He's nothing to say to that. He could just can't pull himself together. Yeah. Or is it actually the cost of that pig that Frank ordered to put into Tom's room?
I wasn't going
to
say.
You're having to foot some of the bill of that.
I wasn't going to say anything.
You'll thank me when it arrives.
You're listening to The Garden Sessions. And still to come on the show, we've got the official Garden Sessions download chart. Will Sofiter Skura still be at number one? That's the question. We don't know the answer to that right now. Dave does, but we don't. We've also got the angle. Dave, give us another hint.
Another hint? I spoil you
oh,
with these.
Guess, give
hey,
us
I spoil. I really, I spoil with you, hey. Sorry, carry on. I apologize.
Hint. It's finally, I found one. It's a happy angle.
No. Happy angle.
Oh, that I'm narrows it down because there aren't many out there.
I'm disappointed.
I don't know. Happy angle, I suppose, is all right. How happy?
Quite happy. It's all nice.
Scale of
end.
1 to 10. 10 being happy, 1 being
sad.
Yeah. 8.
The eight. Opposite.
The opposite of
eight.
That.
So it's
eight.
Not that.
It's an eight. Well,
okay,
that's
right.
Brilliant. They could always be
right.
Happier.
We've also got the featured artist.
Slightly pleased. That's what eight
the
is.
Long-awaited Junction Pool featured artist slot, which Tom recorded before he went off to New Zealand. Tom is in New Zealand, obviously, and we're still awaiting reports back from his World Folk Odyssey.
Yeah,
give
he's
him
not,
time.
There's no dedication. He sent me emails, and all he's been doing is bungee jumping and driving around in the country.
This is a very good point. He did jump off something with a bungee rope attached to his legs.
I did hear that. He's a daredevil and he will do anything for the Folkie cause. But
that's not true either. He did it because he was attached to some girl.
Was he playing Malinky's Follow the Heron at the same time?
It's possible. It's very possible. Knowing Tom.
Anything.
Anyway, also coming up, that's what's coming up. You can look forward You can also look forward to a tune from Corinne Polwart coming up later on, one of her new ones, a teaser for what's to come, I think, from her album. So, at the moment, though, Frank.
It's news. It's folk.
What is it, Frank?
It's the folky news. And the folky news this week brought to you, as ever, in association with Paddy Bort's Wee Folk Club.
Well, every Sunday night at the Oak, we've got the Wee Folk Club at 8:30, an intimate venue, 30 seats, acoustic. It's a great night out. We've got fantastic musicians and singers. Every Sunday night, do come along.
And this week, Sunday the 28th of October at the Wee Folk Club, it's Marion Bradfield, often described as one of Ireland's hidden musical treasures, based in Donegal. To date, she has released 3 solo albums and a live CD. More
sounds
info.
Good.
royal-oak-folk.com.
That's where we are just now. We're sitting in the old Wee Folk Club seats, the ones that don't even get used.
I don't know where the new ones have gone, but we'll hunt them down for next time. Top
Dave,
story.
That's your mission.
Sunday night saw what could be the dawn of a brand new folk singing session at Edinburgh's Antiquary Pub in Stockbridge. The Antiquary Pub, affectionately known by its locals as The Tick. Mm. It was inviting one and all to come along and share a passion for traditional song. Holding court on Sunday were local Bothy balladeer Scott Gardner and regular Thursday night session leader at The Tick, Karen Jones. Jack caught up with Karen after the session and asked her about how... and asked her about the importance of sessions such as these.
There are a lot of instrumental sessions, but that's because there's a lot of instrumentalists. It's very, very important to keep the songs alive, and I'm amazed at how many people have turned up. I'm amazed at how many folk are totally addicted just to singing. The majority of people here don't have instruments. They don't have guitars. They sing a cappella, and it's just, they love it. And they're intent, a lot of folk here are intent on keeping the traditions alive, the Scottish tradition alive, and that is their passion, and that's what it's about. It's about the song. It's not about how good a singer they are. It's about the song.
We can't confirm at this stage, unfortunately, whether the Sunday night singer session in The Tick will be a regular occurrence, but judging by the reception on its maiden voyage, it does seem likely. Garden Sessions listeners can look forward to a special report from Jack and our roving reporter Chris Silver on the next show.
It's a good one.
Following the massive success of last year, Oxjam Music Festival is back.
It's Oxjam time.
Oxjam is a music festival with a difference. From now until the end of October, people like you are putting on thousands of music events across the UK to raise money for Oxfam. There are many events taking place over the length and breadth of the country, covering a broad spectrum of musical genres. Of the folk in Edinburgh, look out for a special concert tonight at the Royal Oak, Infirmary Street, Edinburgh, from former Garden Sessions featured artists Carolyn and Nona Scott, accompanied by Rantum Scantum fiddler Eddie Hansen and Hayley Beavis. Starts at 8 p.m, tickets £4. Keep up to date with all the latest folky news at gardensessions.co.uk/news, and that's the folky news.
Thanks, Frank. Seamless, as always.
Definitely.
It's almost time for the download chart in just a moment. What's still to come on the show, Dave?
Still to come, we have got The Angle coming
hints
up.
Hints you've
always
given us.
I've given you hints aplenty.
Song involves a tree, and it's
a happy one.
It's happy, a happy yeah. angle.
Happy tree.
Should I give you another one?
Three hints.
Three hints.
Go on.
There's a bit of sort of denied love involved.
Denied love.
Right, it just sounds like another...
Doesn't sound very happy to me.
Unhappy folk, yeah. So... Right, enough of this.
The official Garden Sessions download chart!
This is the official Garden Sessions download chart based on free downloads from gardensessions.co.uk.
Free? Did you say free, Dave?
They are indeed free.
It's a folkie's dream.
No pence.
Indeed it is. At 10, it's Down 2 for Behold the Field of Megaliths with Weir. At 9, it's a new entry from Rantum Scantum, Folk 55. At 8, it's a re-entry from the man sitting to my right, Frank Burkitt, an old-timer.
Then we break into a raging chorus. We forget some of the lines, but Tommy still adores us, 'cause it brings him back to the time when he stood on the front line and dreamt of hours spent good old drinking time.
There you go, that's Frank, not just a pretty face.
Oh, I'm blushing.
Not even a face for radio.
What a tune.
At 7, it's a non-mover for Rantum Scantum with Hush. At 6, it's a re-entry for Frank again with a fine drink.
Is that 2?
That's 2 indeed. At 5.
2 in the top 10?
Yep, at 5.
It's rigged.
At 5.
What's at 5, Dave?
At 5?
Up
1,
it's 3 for Frank. Military yes. band featuring Cassandra Steele.
Can't keep him out of this chart.
At 4, it's a re-entry for Sinead Connolly with Inna Shear.
Thank you.
proving at three that she's just like a weed. Beat her back and she comes back double. It's a non-mover for Sinead Connolly with Eileen Oak.
Oh,
you can't say that.
My goodness.
I can say that.
Serious complaint letters.
Yes.
At two.
The poison pen.
At two, variety. A non-mover. Sophie Terscura with Peggy Gordon.
Oh, well.
At one, the official Garden Sessions number one. It's a non-mover again.
Oh, immovable.
Sophie Terscura with Cruel Sister.
For the third time round.
The third time.
Good Lord.
There lived a lady down the North Sea shore. Lay the bend to the bonny brew. Two daughters were the babe she bore. Fa la 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 la. As the one grew bright as is the sun, lay the bend to the bonny brew. So coal black grew the elder. Night came riding by the lady's door. Lay the band to the bonny brew. He travelled far to be there wooed. La 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 la. He courted one with gloves and rings. Lay the band to the bonny brew. But he loved the other. Sister, will you go with me? Lay the band to the bonny brew to watch the ships sail on the sea. La 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 la. She took her sister by the hand. Lay the band to the bonny brew and let her down to the North Sea strand. As they stood on the windy shore, lay the band to the bonny brew. The dark girl threw her sister o'er. Fa la 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 la. Sometimes she sank, sometimes she swung. Lay the band to the bonny brew. Crying sister, reach to me your hand. Fa la 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 la. Oh sister, sister, let me live. Lay the band to the bonny brew, and all that's mine I'll surely give. Fa la 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 la. Your own true love that I'll have and more. Lay the band to the bonny brew, but thou shalt never come ashore. Fa la 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 la. And there she floated like a swan. Lay the band to the bonny brew, the salt sea bore.
Sophie Terscura, Cruel Sister, number one this week in the official Garden Sessions download chart.
Time.
The top four of the chart this week being dominated by two female enigmas, shall we say. We've got a couple of messages here. Bob, location, the Hersheyan Burn, wherever that may be.
Where's the Hersheyan Burn?
Where is it, Dave?
Don't know.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you.
Bob, where's the Hersheyan Burn?
Bob, let us know where the Hersheyan Burn is. His message is, I do love a good garden session.
Who doesn't?
Indeed. But we've got from the Rev in Barcelona. Greetings from Spain is another message.
Greetings to the Rev.
Everyone's sending us messages from around the globe. well, around Europe or wherever the Hirschenberg is. Might not be in Europe. Dave, what's your angle
this week? Tell us.
Sorry, that was a tad confusing. That was just a fast-paced letters bag slapping under the nose.
And we snuck a letters bag in there. There's more to come.
There is indeed. The angle this week is Old Blind Dogs and its Birken Tree.
To gang with me this very night, we'll cuddle till the morning light by all the lave unseen now. And ye will be my dearie, my ain dearest dearie. Yes, ye will be my dearie, can ye meet me at din now? I can afford my mammy gay, she locks the door and keeps the key, and in the morning charges me, and I about the man o. For she says there are deceivers, deceivers, deceivers. She says there are deceivers, ye canna trust in no. Oh, never mind your mammy, she'll nae doot. She met your dad herself, and should she fight, ye can't have tell. She's oftentimes done the same, oh. So lassie, gives your hand on't, your bonny milk white hand on't. Oh, lassie, gives your hand on't, and scorn to lie your limb. Oh lad, my hand I canna gie, but table and zyme and steal the key. Now meet ye at ye on Birken Tree, at Grousdoun in the glen, oh. The den o' lippin' laddie, I canna promise laddie. Oh, den o' lippin' laddie, in case I canna win.
Dogs, Birken Tree, as featured on the album Legacy, released in 1995, and that was Dave's choice for the angle this week. Another classic angle is about to unfurl. Let's say that word again. Dave, what's your angle?
Righty-ho. As always, the song starts off, and there's a guy and a girl.
The song starts off.
Funnily enough, they always start.
If you added together all the times you've said that over the whole load of garden sessions we've done...
3 minutes, 52 seconds.
Have you counted it?
Yeah.
I don't
get on with it.
Anyway, so the song starts off 3 minutes 54.
What's your angle?
And there's this guy who's trying to persuade a girl to sort of get together with me. He's doing his best chat-up lines. Basically, he's saying, you know, come with me, you know, come and we'll lie down together, we'll cuddle, it'll all be nice, no one will bother us.
What do you mean by cuddle?
Cuddle.
Okay.
Just a cuddle?
Just a cuddle. At the moment, that's all he's asking for. Okay. Come and lie down with me and, you know, no one will be around, no one will see us.
Hang on, cuddle to the morning light.
Yeah.
That's a long cuddle.
That's a long cuddle.
Which could lead to more than just cuddling.
Look, it's a cuddle.
Dave, I tell you what.
It's a family show.
Dave, I tell you what, I've got a pop-up book that told me everything. So I'll lend that to you.
Bringing that pop-up book up
anyway,
again.
She says, look, no, it's not going to happen. You know, I've been warned. My mother, she locks me in my room at night. She keeps the key. And she comes in the morning. She teaches me all about men. She's warned me. They're all deceivers. They're all untrustworthy, you know. You can't trust a single one of them.
She locks her in a room and teaches her about men at night.
Comes in the morning. I've locked you in your room for your own safety because men are all bad.
Parenting.
They're all untrustworthy.
Parenting skills, Dave.
So she's not interested in carrying on the line at all.
Well, I don't know. And the guy, well, the guy sort of combats this. He comes back and he says, "Well, hold on a second. Surely your mum met your father at some point, mm-hmm. you know?
I'd imagine so,
if yeah. she gets uppity with you, you know, just say, well, you've done the same yourself. Point. Otherwise, I wouldn't be here, you know?
Ahead of his time."
So he takes her hand and she kind of
breaking
kind
free
of falls
from the pack.
And,
sorry, carry on.
She kind of falls for it. She's saying, "Yeah, okay, then fair enough. You convinced me." And she says, "Well, look, you know, it's not as easy as that." And he says, "It's cool, no, fine. Come and it'll all be fine. Just you've got to break out. That's all you've got to do." And she says, "Okay, I'll meet you down by the birken tree. That's what I'll do. The tree that goes down in the glen. Mm-hmm. I'll meet you there.
Good
but,
place to meet.
You know, don't get your hopes up. Don't count on it. You know, I might not make it.
Oh well,
you know, I've got to steal the key.
Is this in the middle of the night? I assume they're meeting at the birken
yeah,
tree
they're
for
meeting
a cuddle.
At 1 o'clock in the morning.
But dinner, lippin, laddie.
Yeah, don't rely on it. Don't."
But
get
dinner lippin'.
Yeah.
Is that what lippin' officially means, Dave?
Dinner yeah. lippin', laddie. I canna promise, laddie. Dinner lippin', laddie, in case I canna win the
exactly.
ball.
As you're saying, don't hang around. Don't, you know, put all your chickens in one basket.
So what happened? Did
Eggs
she go? Did
so
she
guy,
meet him at the Birkin
so the guy
tree?
Goes to the Birkin tree.
He goes to the Birkin tree and he's waiting
obviously.
There. And all of a sudden he sees someone coming over the glen, and it's her.
It's got to be her. Yeah,
it's her.
It's her.
Oh, that's
and it's all cool. Okay. She comes in, she sits down beside him.
Didn't leave us in much suspense there, Dave, as to who was coming over the glen.
And they're together. And he says, "I'm overjoyed. I'm so happy. Finally,
Co-he
you've come.
And preed his cherry moo."
Yeah.
Explain.
Well, Quohi is said he.
Yeah.
So
obviously.
He said, "You know, I'm
yeah,
overjoyed."
Yeah. We're more interested in the cherry moo.
That's his red lips. His cherry mouth.
Ah, it's cherry moo.
Cherry moo. Makes sense now. Yeah.
Yeah. Gosh. You know, my genes come. We're together. We're going to be together forever, and they're both happy because they both got each other.
That is a nice angle.
That is actually
that's
kind
a
of.
Very nice
so what do they do? They just sort of. We don't really hear what happens.
They cuddle till the morning light.
Yeah, but how did she deal with her mother? And her mother obviously would have found out about this eventually. That, needless to say that.
Leave that to a prequel.
All right, Birkin tree 2, Birkin bush. That'll be the second.
The
one.
Beginning.
Yeah.
Let's not mock the
Birkin
tune,
forest. That's the next one.
Come on.
Right, Dave, what's the moral?
The moral is that if you strive for what is most important to you, eventually you'll win out and everything will be fine.
Determination. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, determination.
If you believe it's right.
Stand up for what you believe in. Yeah,
that kind of thing.
The same moral
it's
to
that,
every
feel.
Angle you've ever done.
I didn't claim there was lots of morals in the world. I just claimed I could decipher one.
Dave, that your angle?
Yep.
And that's the angle. I think we've got time for another wee cheeky letter.
We do.
Dave, do you want to take the next one?
Yes, we've got a letter here from Tasha in Brighton. And it says, "Hey monkeys, enjoying the sessions
monkeys.
From Brighton these days." I don't know, maybe she thinks we're all monkeys.
That was be that time that she saw you with like a massive sort of net bag
soup.
Of bananas. That's what I was thinking about.
What do monkeys eat?
That's the
fruit
monkeys eat.
Anyway.
Of course.
Regardless of whether she thinks we're monkeys or not, enjoying the sessions from Brighton these days, really missing Tom, dreaming about New Zealand recently, hope you're having a great time, email
who hasn't
me.
Been?
Love, Tasha. And four kisses,
four
each
kisses.
Of us.
Four kisses.
And one extra.
No
four.
Kiss for Silver.
No.
No kiss for Silver, but everyone else gets one. Or maybe it is for Silver and maybe one of us is down a kiss.
I don't think it's worth really chatting about, do you?
Is it worth looking into? No. I don't think so. What's coming up on the show, Frank?
Coming up on the show, we've got the featured artist that is Junction Pool. The lost
folk
recordings have been
hear the voice of Tom.
Found. The voice of Tom.
From
I know that'll
the
be nostalgic.
World
nostalgic from us all. But we're going to be listening.
Harris Playfair, incidentally, of Junction Pool.
Of course, of course. But before that, we have Corinne Polwart singing a song called Better Things.
Ten 10,000 years of big ideas distilled into a billion fears. A grand design, a shiny rocket, a bullet in a bully's pocket. So mesmerized by particles, we disregard the articles. The ones we wrote to keep the peace, sullied now in blood and greed and grease. And is this the best that we can do? Oh, I can think of better things. Can't you? With the devil's pitchfork in our hands, we turn a night to foreign lands to demonstrate our just dominion and iterate our just opinion. Yet these are the hands that fix the bones, the ones that build with sticks and stones. These are the hands that plant the tree, the ones that pull the newborn baby free. And is this the best that we can do? Oh, I can think of better things, can you? But a carnal tomb in which the darkness holds no power, neither does the final hour. We may lament the deadly art of tiny atoms torn apart, of visions that we can't return, and future fires in which we fear we'll burn. Yet this is the art of those before who found a cure within the core, the noble mind behind the ray that eased our earthly pains away. So was this the best that we can do? Oh, I can think of better things, can't you? Distilled into a billion fears, a grand design, a shiny rocket, a bullet in a bully's pocket. Is this the best that we can do? Oh, I can think of better things, can't you? Yes, I can think of better things that hands can make and hearts can sing.
One of the first recordings from Kareem Powart since she became a mother. It's A Taste of Things to Come, and it's available to download from her MySpace, which is myspace.com, Kareem Powart. And that song's called Better Things. You're listening to The Garden Sessions, gardensessions.co.uk. Contact us at podcast at gardensessions.co.uk. We're available on Radio Britfolk, radiobritfolk.co.uk, and 98.8 FM in the Edinburgh area, Leith FM.
Where Leith lives.
It does, Frank. Thank you.
Anytime.
We're coming closer, coming closer to our featured artist slot with Junction Pool, but at the moment, I've got another letter to read, and this one's from Tom.
Oh, yeah. We're sending letters in now.
Now, on the last show, Angles compared Frank's it's an ill-advised purchase. Basically, this sort of ceramic pig that he decided to buy. The cost's spiraling out of control. I don't know what's happened. The postage, etc. Angles suggested it was a good replacement for Tom because it was large and gluttonous and sits in the corner. Tom writes, large and gluttonous and sits in the corner. How many festivals did you cover in 2007, Angles? How many folkies did you interview, and who's on an odyssey in New Zealand? Consider yourself told. Do you have anything to say to that?
No, I don't have anything to say to that. I consider myself well and truly told, but if I'm getting a telling, Frank should get a telling as well, because
why?
The spiralling cost of this ridiculous ceramic pig, which has got me into so much trouble, now means that we can't afford the snooker table in Tom's room.
So all we've got
is a pig on a table.
Well, I'm telling you, when it arrives, you will thank me.
No,
that pig.
I've seen pictures of the pig, Frank.
Pictures do not tell you anything. You
when
will
it
experience
arrives. It's always tomorrow, Frank.
You boys are gonna be, you're gonna be on your knees groveling for forgiveness. You really are when this pig arrives, when it gets here.
Dave, what's coming now?
What's coming now is our featured artist.
Hooray!
We've been talking up for, well, a couple of weeks now. We've been trying to find it. It's Junction Pool. Tom met up with Harris Playfair and talked about Junction Pool and the new album, self-titled album, Junction Pool.
So I'm in the Ark pub in Edinburgh, and I've just seen a fantastic set by Junction Pool, a fantastic collaboration of musicians from Kelso and the Borders, my own hometown. I've just finished a marvellous set here up in Edinburgh, and I'm joined by Harris Playfair, the pianist with this band. Harris, welcome to the Garden Sessions.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Tom. Cheers.
Junction Pool seems to be a collaboration of musicians who've kind of developed in an eclectic kind of way, a bit like maybe the Peat Bog Fairies did. A number of different musicians who play different in different styles and have developed their own unique style. How did the band sort of come together in the first place?
Well, there's kind of two strands to this story, because one is the fact that the band is obviously made up of quite a few ex-pupils of Kelso High School, but they're from two different generations of Celtic groups that I've been running since I started there about 150 years ago. The other thing is that they've really started moulding themselves into a band of very talented but focused musicians who all have their own particular tastes and styles. And so it's been a slow metamorphosis from, say, a post-school band into a fully functioning, hopefully serious band that everybody can really sort of enjoy.
I believe you've got a couple of tunes for us. What's the first of these, and tell us a wee bit about it.
Well, the first one is a tune called Bah Hamburg, which is a tune I learned from Aidan O'Rourke. As well as teaching at Kelso, I've been lucky enough to be involved with summer schools. I was actually over in Canada last year, and for 2 years in a row, I taught at Folkworks in Durham, which is probably Britain's biggest, largest traditional music summer camp. And I was lucky enough to have Aidan, who was stuck for a mixed ensemble, and just came in and co-taught with me for the week. And we really hit it off. And in the gala concert on the Saturday night in Durham, he came out with this tune called Bah Hamburg, which he kind of played it once to me, he said, and then realised how difficult it was, because it's basically 7 and 6 all the way through. He said, no, maybe we won't have time to do that. And there was like a ferret down a drainpipe. I said, no, we've got to do this, because it was just such a challenge to me to learn this before the gig at night. So I thought it was just an incredible piece of music.
Thank you.
was Bar Hamburg by Junction Pool, and I'm still joined by Harris Playfair of the fantastic band Junction Pool in the Ark pub here in Edinburgh. Now, Harris, you combine the roles of music teacher and performer in a kind of traditional folky band. What challenges does this present, and how do you manage that?
I don't manage it very well these days because they're all big enough to have their own opinions, and sometimes I find myself in a tiny minority of one. So although Mary Ann Kennedy called me Captain Playfair on Radio Scotland when we did our live session a couple of weeks ago, I sometimes wonder if really that's the true name.
So you've got another tune for us, I believe. What's that going to be called? And
this is the Big Welly set, which is like the opener for our album, which we recorded, I think, two years ago, Castle Sound, a year and a half ago. And we originally called it the Labatine set simply because it's a homage to Labatine Souriant. It's one of the ones that seems to have got quite a lot of airplay. And the story behind this is that James Thompson, our kind of lead piper, he goes right back to the very first Celtic group I had when I was at Kelso when I first started. He's a very talented piper, and he's always brought tunes of interest along, which are really quite inspiring. And this whole set of tunes grew out of the fact that he'd managed to get a set of border pipes, which are quite chromatic. I think they're almost totally chromatic. And he was so ecstatic about this. He turned up on my doorstep one afternoon in the summer, like a kid with a new toy. He said, "We must go into the vintage bar, which is my neighbour's bar, and have a tune." And he rattled off these three tunes, and we were just about to settle into the usual session, which probably kind of dissolves into something you can't really quite recall. But we decided for once to sit down at the computer instead, and 3.5 hours later I had the arrangement completely in the bag, brass parts and all.
Fantastic. So this is the Big Welly set by Junction Pool. Thank you. was the Big Welly set by Junction Pool. I'm still joined by Harris Playfair here in the Ark Pub in Edinburgh. You're listening to the Garden Sessions. Harris, how can people find out about the Junction Pool if they want to hear more of your music?
Well, we've got two websites. It's junctionpool.com, which is a fabulous website put together by a good friend of mine who's Kayleigh band I play in every weekend. And we've got an info@junctionpool.com inbox, so anybody who wants to leave any kind of messages or book us, which is obviously nice, they're more than welcome to do so. The other website, which is frequently used a lot, is our MySpace website. I think it's just myspace.com/junctionpool. And again, you can peruse any information about what the band's doing or what it's not doing, because I think this is our last official gig for a while, so anybody wants to come in and have a browse, listen to the music, and give us a chance to play, we'd be delighted to do it.
Well, thanks very much for joining us on the Garden Sessions, Harris, and congratulations on the magnificent set tonight. Cheers.
Thanks very much, Tom. Mm-hmm.
The long-awaited featured artist slot with Junction Pool, or should I say, Harris Playfair of Junction Pool. The Garden Session seems a hell of a lot more professional when Tom is on it.
Just no, nonsense. Nonsense. He was cramping our creative abilities.
Yeah, you would say that, though.
He never made any financial decisions like that pig.
Look, come on. Come on now. Enough justice about the pig.
When we see the pig, we may change our minds.
Exactly.
Until we see the pig, you're a fool.
What can we look forward to on next week's show, Dave?
On next week's show, we'll have everything as usual. We'll have another angle. We'll have the Garden Sessions download chart. Will Sophie still be at number one?
Will
can
she
make it four?
I think no.
Has anyone ever made it for?
Yes. Frank's had five. Chung had eight.
Chung had eight.
Yep.
No, he didn't.
Yes, he did.
He struck eight. A whole lot of luck on the Penny Falls.
He did.
He did. Truth be told, he struck a lot of luck.
Podcast.
Well.
And this will probably be the last of our shows that we do in the cellar.
Let's hope so, because I mean, it is a nice venue, you know. It's good.
Lovely.
But it's haunted beyond belief.
But it is. It is.
You can't do a podcast or a radio show.
It's not a pleasant way to spend an evening.
It's very difficult. There are a lot of technical hitches this show again. So.
And it's nothing to do with Jack. It's all the poltergeists.
Yes.
It is.
Entirely the poltergeists.
Anyway, second that.
So yeah, next week's show, there's a report on the session at the Antiquary as well, we can look forward to, I did with Chris Silver. We can possibly even hope to hear some recordings from tonight's gig at the Royal Oak. We'll just have to go upstairs.
Eddie Hadson.
It's Hayley Beavis.
Hayley Beavis.
Anyway, it's all very exciting, and we're looking forward to that next week on the Garden Sessions. Another fantastic show. It will be episode 45, because this was episode 44. GardenSessions.co.uk is the place to find everything. Contact us at podcast@GardenSessions.co.uk. Please do. And don't forget that we're available on Radio Britfolk, radiobritfolk.co.uk, 98.8 FM in the Edinburgh area, Leith FM. Till next time, from myself, Jack Foster, Frank Burkitt, and Dave the Angles Gimble, take it easy.
See you later.
Cheerio.